I am doing this video mostly to make fun of Dell's wake and learn function, but I thought it also might be helpful for someone to understand the issue they are having. The issue is, I enabled wake and learn on my Dell Optiplex workstation and now it does automatically reboot. So, I enabled wake and learn like Dell wanted me to do in their manual. I turned on the wake and learn function and disabled deep sleep option in BIOS. I skipped the Windows related steps as I'm running Linux on the machine, but this is not important here. Now, if you did so yourself, you probably noticed that every time you try to shut down your machine, it reboots after a few seconds. The reason is, you just disabled ability to turn your machine off. And if the machine cannot turn off, it will automatically reboot. By disabling deep sleep option, you disabled S5 and S4 state of sleep in your machine. Dell even was so nice that they explained what these states are. In short, S5 is when your computer is completely turned off and S4 is hibernation, also called save to disk. It creates save file on your hard drive to resume from where you left. So, now you know why your computer reboots automatically. But I really want to appreciate Dell's approach to wake and learn. To enable functionality of powering on your machine remotely, you first must disable its ability of being powered off. Let that sink in. You want to remote start your machine, but you cannot turn it off. Why in the world would you need to start your machine if it cannot be turned off? Please explain me, Dell. Also, the reasoning they are trying to sell you in this manual is complete crap. I've got an HP machine of similar age at work and it wakes on LAN with no problem from S5 state. This is just nuts. But while I'm at it, I can tell you my workaround to this cursed solution. Instead of completely disabling deep sleep, disable it only on S5 state. What this will allow you to do is waking your machine from hibernation. So, instead of turning your machine off, you must hibernate it. In Linux, this can be done with systemctl hibernate command. I tested it and it works. I know that this does not solve the problem entirely, but it's the next best thing you can do in this situation. Thanks for watching.